Thank you so much for joining us on a brand new episode of 420 Grams. Now, it's been less than 48 hours since we put out our last episode, where we were, of course, talking about that merger between ATK and Mohan Bagan. Old news, but we were, of course, talking about the result of that first board meeting. But humne pata nahi kaun se vitamin khaye hain, pata nahi kaun se booster injection le liye, ki 48 ghante ke beech mein hum aapke liye le aaye hamara dusra episode. Because if you go by a track record, either sometimes we've gone missing for 6 months, either we do an episode a day for 7 days nonstop. So I think we're on that tangent right now, where episodes will keep coming to you dhadadhad one day at the, you know, ek se karkar ek aayega. Now, the reason I said Mohan Bagan at the start was because Mohan Bagan ki baat hogi. But today we're talking about the other Calcutta club. The two Calcutta clubs, if you love Indian football, then sabse pehle aapke zehen mein do naam aayenge, whether you're from Calcutta or you're in some other part of the country. The two names that will come, that is Mohan Bagan and East Bengal. And today we're talking about the red and gold of East Bengal. And joining us to talk about the red and gold of East Bengal is the owner of the Minerma Football Academy, Ranjit Bajaj. Someone who's, of course, been around Indian football for a while and has tasted a lot of success. Ranjit, thank you so much for joining us on the show. Yeah? And we've, of course, started going live nowadays. क्योंकि हमारा बताओ होता क्या था कि हम लोग शो पे आके इतनी बकवास करते थे एंड यू नो वेर इन लव विद FSDL, वेर इन लव विद IIFF एंड देन आफ्टर रिकॉर्डिंग द शो वी
से ऑनली वे इन लव विद ईच अदर
एज वेल एंड देन वी विल से अच्छा लेट्स एडिट दिस लेट्स एडिट दैट आउट तो यू नो आधी कहानी आती थी सो वी सेड स्क्रू दैट मैन नो मोर एडिटिंग धड़ाधड़ जो जो बोलेगा वो ही रहेगा So, and I think you're the perfect guy to have on the show for that.
I was just going to say that, bro. First of all, it's awesome being here. And if that's the way the show is going to go, unedited, so no holds barred. So, I don't know. They can't ban me anymore. They can't ban me anymore. I don't know about you guys.
no, they can't. They. I don't know. I think we're on the verge of that. मोहन बगान से तो हमने हाथ दूर ही कर लिया क्योंकि नाउ यू जॉइंड द ISL बैंडवैगन सो आई वाज टेलिंग माय फ्रेंड सिद्धांत कि भाई अब प्रेस रिलीज प्रेस मीट्स के लिए आपको तो न्योता नहीं आने वाला तो आप वो सब तो छोड़ ही दो बट द पॉइंट बीइंग वी आर ऑन फेसबुक गाइस राइट नाउ एंड ऑफ कोर्स वी आर गोइंग टू बी टॉकिंग विद रंजीत अबाउट दिस प्रपोज्ड टेक ओवर ऑफ शेयर्स द शेयर्स दैट ऑफ कोर्स बिलोंग टू क्वेस्ट कॉर्प जस्ट बिफोर वी स्टार्ट टॉकिंग टू हिम इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस For Ranjit, if you have any questions for Siddhant or me, please do post them over there. And we, of course, we will try answering as many as we can. So, main mudde pe aunga seedha, Ranjit. Because, see, a while back, the news was that Quest Corp is owning a certain majority number of shares. And while, of course, the split has happened, it's not completely happened. Wo kahin na kahin atka hua hai. And the reason being, they want someone to buy off from their shares. And then, uske do din baad kahani aati hai ki Ranjit Bajaj has put his hat in the ring. So could you give us the timeline? When did you put your hat into the ring? How did things progress and where do you stand currently?
Okay, so the situation is like this. When I was, this has been going on, the Quest and East Bengal saga has been going on for a couple of months now. We came to know very early during the season that Quest is going to be departing from this agreement. And they had made it their intentions very clear that come hell or high water, no matter what, by the end of the season, we are going to get out. So everybody knew that, but apparently they were talking to a lot of investors, bankers and all and whatever investors before this COVID thing happened. And there was a lot of interest. So they really thought that that's the news I've got. They thought that they will be able to offload it and not at least get up from the table with a loss. They had spent certain amount of money in acquiring the shares. That means apparently they had put 4 crores in the account of East Bengal when they did it. For running the operations into the club account, and also the amount of money which they've spent over the last 2 years. So they were always looking for investors. But when this happened, that all the investors suddenly just jumped the ship. Why? Because of COVID-19 happening, they were left in a situation where either they were going to have to give away the shares free of cost back to them or give it to the whatever money they can get from the market. So you have to understand that Quest is a company and Ajit Isaac is a face of the company. He is not the owner of the company. That means he's answerable to the shareholders of Quest.
Yeah.
And Quest Corp has invested from Quest Corp. So when the shareholders, obviously shareholders meetings happen and when they come to know that they could have got some money out of it and they've just let it go. So that will not go down well. So that's why they are taking this route and making sure that they see every option. So when 2 weeks ago I came to know that this is happening and they still don't have an investor, and it actually might, that time we didn't know what's going to happen with Mohun Bagan. That means today we come to know that, okay, most of the Mohun Bagan fans are happy and 90% of their demands have been met. There was a lot of talk of in town that, you know, the logo might be changed and then the colors might be changed and a lot of identity might be lost. The same thing I didn't want to happen to East Bengal. So, see, even if I can't, the main demand of East Bengal fans is that they want to play into the ISL. Even though
I don't get it, man. I'm sorry. I just don't understand that.
Yeah, so they're saying ISL, ISL, ISL. But they have to understand that if they want to get into ISL, if they ask them a simple question that tomorrow, will you play in some other color or in some other logo or other name other than East Bengal and we'll put you in the ISL today? I'll tell you 99.9%, 100.1% will say no, there's no chance. Either we want to play in ISL, we want to play with our name. So if you want...
ये तो मोहन बगान वाले भी तो बोल रहे होंगे पहले, पर तो मर्जर हो गया आप तो पूरा का पूरा।
अब उनका मोहन बगान की तो बात करें।
Yeah, but so it was a prayer. We were hanging on a prayer for Mohun Bagan. That means it was hope. Even if they had not gone with those colors or the logo, we couldn't have done anything. Mohun Bagan fans couldn't have done anything about it because it was just a hope and prayer. They are the actual owners. The same way, the person who owns the 70% can actually do anything with the club. So instead of it going to a person who, I'm just giving an example, nothing against Panwalas at all, but suppose a Panwala has made enough money and he wants to put his Pan in front of East Bengal's logo, that becomes actually possible. Why? Because he owns 70% of the shares. And he may be a guy who's just looking to make a quick buck, that holding onto the shares for that amount, not putting any money for the next year, and just looking for a sellout. Because he knows even if he gets 10, if he sends 10 crores, East Bengal is much worth more than 10, 15, 18 crores, which they're looking for. So he knows he will make money. But that is...
understand that. That's a business decision.
But that's a wrong reason to get into East Bengal. And that's the same kind of shit you'll be getting yourself into with Mohun Bagan, hanging on a thread, hanging on a prayer and hope. Whereas my idea was that even if it means putting, see, there are two options. One is that I get the sporting rights for them. Main thing is about sporting rights. Mm-hmm. So I buy the shares of PES and I sit very quietly on the side. Okay. And I say, okay, fine. They've apparently already signed a bunch of players, which they had no right to do. They've already signed those players at whatever salary they have decided. They've not even asked the next investor. So actually they are invalid, but if they want to go ahead and do it, they can. I'll sit quietly. All the fans should know that I have come in just for the sporting rights so they can start participating in competitions, man.
Yeah.
Whenever. Right now, forget about ISL. You can't even play in Calcutta League. Forget about ISL.
Calcutta League.
Yeah. So the first thing to do is get your sporting rights back and then look for an investor. You can't say, I want to look for an investor also and I want to look for the right person and I want my sporting rights also and I want him to come and pit 100 crores and he should get into the ISL this year. It can't happen all of a sudden. If it had to happen, it would have happened. And this is the worst time for this to happen. It will not happen right now. So get the sporting rights back. So if they want to run the club, good kudos to them. Let them run the club. But I'm not going to be paying any money for them to pay their players, being honest with you. Mm. But if I have to run the club, my club will be running to win the I-League and to give them the trophy which they've not got for the last so many years. So that they can tell the Mohun Bagan fans that you cannot stick one up on us because we've got a trophy as well. Which, by the way, if they leave right now and go to the ISL, will always be a sticking point in the history of East Bengal that they have not won a trophy in the I-League. Which I am telling you is very much possible because...
But Ranjit, if you come into a place like East Bengal and someone who's so passionate about the game and who's, of course, tasted success with his team, so aisa nahi ki matlab bas bole ja rahe ho, sir, aapne kiya hai फील्ड पे किया है, ठीक है, तो आपको पता है क्या होता है, आप कैसे आप मुझे कह रहे हो कि यू विल नॉट डू एनीथिंग एंड यू विल टेक अ स्टेप बैक एंड यू विल जस्ट लेट एवरीथिंग हैपन इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू व्हेन यू पुट इन द काइंड ऑफ मनी बिकॉज़ वी नो द काइंड ऑफ मनी इट्स अपवर्ड्स ऑफ 5 एंड 6 सीआर आई थिंक
आज का पहला पर्सनल सवाल
नहीं मैं बट वैलिड सवाल है सर वैलिड मैं तो कह रहा
हूं नहीं 100% वैलिड है कि अगर आप फुटबॉल क्लब में इतना इन्वेस्टमेंट कर रहे हैं स्पेशली एज अ पर्सन हु इज been involved, like you said, and won the I-League, been champions of India, no less, and have players now playing in several national teams across age groups, and etc., etc. How will you take a backseat? How will you take a side?
The point has to be that either, because see, I'm not Quest, so I am not, I don't know about football. I damn well know about football. exactly my point. So either they let me run the team my way and I will guarantee them success. So all the plaudits which come with it are mine and all the brickbats which come with it are mine as well. But if they expect me to do what Quest did, that means pay them the money so that they can run the team and do what they've been doing for the last 15 years, which has not been a success because its stats show that, I'm not willing to do that. But if it means just they want help right now because they want sporting rights, I'm okay because I know if I can help them right now, even when I get up, I can sell it to an investor and make a buck. But then that is my job. My job should be very clear that I am helping them get back the sporting rights and I'm going to get out of it the moment I get my first chance.
So would I be right in saying you're coming in for a short-term solution?
Short-term solution so that the same thing, they don't fall in the same predicament. Hmm. I have no qualms of being an owner of East Bengal because I don't believe clubs like East Bengal and Mohun Bagan can be owned. You can be a servant of that club. You can be a custodian of the rights of the club. The fans have to be the owners. End of the day, if it happens that I have the control, my idea is to go on the Barcelona model or the Osasuna model or the Real Madrid model. And in fact, there's so many German clubs who have been doing it for donkey's years and have been successful. In fact, there are only three or four clubs who are not doing it in Germany. And now Leipzig and all those clubs.
Yeah.
So this is possible and it's possible with the best in European clubs. It's the possible way running it in millions of dollars investments with the fans owning the main stakes. The difference in Barcelona and all are their members, which the East Bengal people are already doing, members. But the only difference is they don't own shares. Here, I rather sell the 70% shares individually to club members. So that and make sure that there's a memorandum and there's a contract which says that the club shares can only be sold back to the club and they cannot be traded to another person. Nowhere in the future can be a takeover by buying all the shares together.
Yeah.
So making sure that for the next 100 years also, there's no problem with anyone coming and trying to take over the club. And the club, and with that happening, all meetings will be decided by the actual stakeholders meeting with all the fans being there. So it will probably, it can be a revolution. Why? Because why are clubs shutting down so much? Even the clubs with such great fans and fan base are finding it difficult to run. For example, Mohammedan Sporting. But I'm sure if Mohammedan Sporting was run in the number of fans they have and each person just pays 100 rupees also, they've got enough budget to run it for 1 year. But the fans actually pay more. They pay something like over 1,000 rupees to support their club over a year. But none of that money actually reaches the club. So that system has to come.
I have a question, but I'll wait for my brother, Siddhant, because you look like you've done a few push-ups and come on the show. So, bhai, aap pehle puchho, fir uske baad main jata hun.
Nahin, I was just wanting to ask, actually, it's a half serious question, but if you do sell or manage to get into a situation where you sell, or what do you regard as the feasibility? I completely get, and obviously it's something you've thought through quite extensively and looked at different models of club ownership as well as club management and how these things work, as well as considering the legacies of clubs like East Bengal and Mohun Bagan, and where fans, I mean, the reason why we get first or think about it first when you think of Indian football is because of that fan base that they've accumulated over their 100-year history. So, what do you imagine an AGM being like with, theoretically, you sitting there with the coach or with whatever management, and then maybe 1,000 or 5,000 or 10,000 shareholders coming at you with everything they've got?
See, there'll be problems, but at least it'll be a democracy the way, and that's exactly, by the way, when Barcelona did it, Real Madrid did it, their meetings were a big mess.
Chaos.
But they used to be total chaos, but they got it right. And the same way we've got parliaments in the world where I've seen chairs being thrown at legislators, and it happens on a daily basis. We see videos of that. We see Indian parliaments and state legislative assemblies where our MLAs are doing the same thing. So it's not that these things will not happen. Wherever there's passion and love for something and it's a democratic setup, these things will happen. And that's actually the kind of advantage of it, that no one person can have his say. And because there's a majority, it'll always be done in the good of the club. So these problems are inherent with a democracy. Otherwise, we would have been like China and we would have got 100 gold medals as well. If we really put 1 lakh Indians in a school, athletes to school, and it's like a concentration camp, trust me, I'll also be able to produce 100 medals in the Olympics. Simple.
Fair enough. Ranjit, see, हमारे भाई तो आपको थोड़ा आगे ले गए, saying that what if you get the shares? मैं तो कह रहा हूँ, sir, let's talk practically now, first and foremost. So I've been reading some stuff here online, and now there's so much shit that is written online for Indian football. So I'm not saying it's verified, but there is, of course, potential investors, including Procter Gamble, Red Chillies Entertainment, ITC, Bandhan Bank, and even former ATK FC co-owner Harsh Nihotia. Then on top of
I forgot about Abhishek Bachchan yesterday.
Oh, Abhishek Bachchan has also come into the picture now.
Very big news, and it was all posters out and memes and all that Abhishek Bachchan is going to be coming in. Right. So,
My point being that A, there is that clause that the first mover advantage is with East Bengal. First mover advantage is with East Bengal.
The clause, people are not understanding the clause. The clause doesn't say first mover advantage. So it basically says, when I say ROFR, right of first refusal, selling the shares to them. So Quess, if somebody gives an offer to Quess, they're supposed to go with the same offer to the minority stakeholders and give them a chance to acquire those shares. Only if they are not able to acquire those shares, then it goes to automatically to whoever Quess wants to give it to. So if now they have a chance, that offer has been made to them, that's what the offer is. Now they have a chance to actually say that we'll be making this payment, and there'll be a date obviously before the payment has to come. If they do that, good enough. And that's when all these investors you're talking about have to now stand up and be counted. Because there's no point of talking about Procter & Gamble and Red Chillies Entertainment and Abhishek Bachchan or anyone you mentioned, unless they stand up and now do it. See, the point is that I like to be the pusher. And I have started seeing myself as being the pusher in Indian football, not pushing drugs, pusher. So when I say pusher, I mean, I push people into action because unko sharam aa jati hai. Same way, like I bloody pushed AIFF into action, ke inki sali practice shuru karwa lo. And other people in our group, under 16s, that means South Korea, Uzbekistan, Australia, I have been practicing for 1.5 months. And you're not a better team than them, you're worse than them, you need to start practicing. And if you don't have a place, I'll give you my venue free of cost and all that. So they got on something and they've got something done apparently in Goa. They had to do that. Same with under 17 girls. So there were these girls who had not got any money there. So all I had to do was, they said the reason AIFF gave was that we didn't find their bank accounts. We couldn't find the details. And I didn't hire a detective. I just asked on social media, on Twitter, that please tell me if anybody can give me the details. Within 10 minutes, somebody got me the bank accounts of each and every girl. And within 1 hour, the money was 10,000 rupees was transferred. But AIFF saw that it's not our itni besti ki hai, so we should do something. And next day, 50,000 rupees was transferred to every girl's account. So even if there's a, so now, for example, Mr. Neetu Sarkar, he's been telling his fans fans of East Bengal for the last 10 years, investor.
Yeah, every day you hear a new story, investor RI.
In a different story. And I want him to be pushed to a place where he knows that either, oh my God, Ranjit Bajaj is going to come in, or I better get an investor. If I have one, it better be shown. Or the fans come to know that this guy has been blowing smoke out of his ass for the last 10 years.
Just one thing. Are you aware that Quess, other than the shares, they also want to say that jo dues bache hain, we want to offload them and whoever comes on. Yeah, so means it's not just the 5-6, yeah, jo bhi, I'm not giving the figure here, but uske alawa bhi extra kuch aur hai.
3.5 crores. That's a figure of the what they had to apparently spend on the cricket team.
Which yeah.
They have not been paying for the last 1.5-2 years. And if that's in the contract, it depends on the owner. That means whatever price I've offered to him is not including that money. And
exactly.
If that money is going to be counted, it's going to be cut from there. So that is why where I have sleepless nights now, that becomes a very measly kind of an offer. And anyone can come and take it over. That's what I'm trying to say. They should not now Quess. In fact, if I was Neetu Sarkar, I would be on the first call to me saying that, okay, let's get the sporting rights. And okay, let's you sit outside. We'll do everything. And then whenever we find an investor, you'll get your money. Out. And I know for sure my money is safe. My East Bengal money, whatever I spend on it, it will be safe. I will get the money back. But I am not sure whoever the next investor is right now in this desperate situation from Quess, who can buy it out and do whatever it wants with it. How do we stop it? yeah, we may hope and pray that it will be the right person, but it may not be.
So, Ranjit, straight up question is that with a club with so much history, such a strong fan base, and as you say, like even if each fan gives 100 rupees or whatever they are capable of giving, you manage to accumulate a total that is quite substantial. And especially when you're talking in a context of the kind of money that we are talking about, I mean, anyone would consider it from the outside almost a freebie, a giveaway deal for a club with the kind of thing that East Bengal has.
And bro, sorry for cutting you, it's not even now, it's a generational thing. That means you're guaranteed income for generations to come because it's a generational support, it'll never go away.
And not just income also, I mean, everything else that goes with it. Of course, income is, and especially if you're looking at a corporate takeover, it becomes quite significant. And we were talking about Mohan Bagan the other day in the same context as we're talking about Indian Railways. So, ek din aap railways privatize kar rahe hain, agle din defense privatize kar rahe hain, agle din clubs privatize kar rahe hain, and eventually everything becomes same sort of scenario, and the whole concept of club goes away from football clubs. So we can get into that. But what I wanted to ask you was, has, to your knowledge at least, has there been any conversation between the leadership of the club and the fans to say, look, it might come down to this, where we might be in a situation where we don't have the sporting rights and therefore we cannot even play in the Calcutta League. Are you guys up for pitching in to pick up this stake? And if so, what's been the result of that conversation?
Unfortunately, that is what these guys were supposed to do. That is why they were elected in the first place, that they were the representatives of the fans. They are not the owners. But they are
they're officials.
But I'm unfortunately the same way for Mohan Bagan. Now, yes, it's worked out to be a great deal. But I'm sure they never asked the fans whether they want to go into this deal. If they actually had spelt out what this deal meant, I'm sure that none of the Mohan Bagan fans would have said yes. Why? Mm-hmm. Because it meant that there was a chance of the identity being going. Now, the same way here, they needed to talk to the fans and ask them, because the main stakeholders, they don't realize are the fans. And it should always be on the decisions should be left on the fans. And then you can never go wrong. Why? Because if you have majority of your fans on your side, whatever decisions you take, even if they go wrong and they turn out wrong, because it's the fan decision, they'll still support you.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, game alag hai na. Can I just
follow up? Sorry.
Ji, bhai.
Just because this theory was also sort of propagated that, and you yourself have come out and said that maybe you're the person that is the instigator or the catalyst in Indian football, or at least that's how you view yourself. Have you ever got the feeling that in terms of your offer for the shares, that kind of you are being used by the existing owners of these shares in
good
East Bengal?
Good question,
right?
Sawal acha hai.
Kind of leverage with all these Procter and Gambles and big names.
That's being honest with you. That's an open admission from their side that this would have never been pushed on. I mean, if they would have said that ABC is coming, they wouldn't have been pushed into action. Because now they know that this kind of thing has happened and I can actually come into the picture and be actually in control of what they were trying to do. They were trying to get Quest out for a reason. They were trying to get Quest out because they had lost all control over the club. There was no decision-making ability left in their hands and they were not liking it. So the reason they're getting them out is for the same reason. And then they see that, okay, Quest is somebody who you probably could have dealt with. With me coming into the picture, it's not that going to be that easy cup of tea that they'll be able to push me around the same way Quest can. Because Quest has gone out of it only because they have a bad taste in the mouth. In fact, it was a very sweet deal. These guys have not used Quest properly. It was a very sweet deal, somebody coming and paying you all the money for 20 crores a year for your running the club. And you're still getting most of your way. And trust me, 1 year or second year, East Bengal would have gone in. And by the way, there's a misconception in the contract that which says that if East Bengal doesn't reach the ISL, they can get out. No, East Bengal can't get out. The investor can get out. The contract says it's investor's favor. So investor can get out if they don't play in the top league. East Bengal has no right to get out of the contract. And being honest, now I'm telling you, let's make it a fact here, because yesterday I was hearing that FSDL is really softening up to the idea of East Bengal being in the ISL and they might relax stuff for them. Again, it's again a catalyst pushing them because they don't buy bloody hell. FS doesn't, DL doesn't want me
as a bunch.
Thoda wishful thinking nahi ho gaya sir, bandra crore to gaant bandh ke rakhi hui hai unne. Bandra, they will not give them revenue. They see, but you don't understand, they will earn more than the 15 crore. Every match which Mohun Bagan has with East Bengal, their TRPs will be off the roof. The sponsorships will be off the roof. The telecast, the money which they will get for that particular match will beat all other matches, including the ISL final and including the ISL semi-finals and whatever bloody matches you have.
Yeah.
Including Bangalore versus Chennai, you know, any match you call it. The first match of East Bengal and Mohun Bagan in the ISL will be a bloody sellout, especially because you don't have crowds there. Now, you'll have an empty stadium. So, that money, 15 crores, they can get in one match or this, that the derby, two matches, the two derbies they have. And the kind of property they can make is 50% of what they can make without East Bengal. See, the whole Mohun Bagan is huge. Why? Because of East Bengal.
Yeah.
East Bengal is huge because of Mohun Bagan. If you take one of them out of each other's life, they become 50% of the club. There is no romance left in it.
You know, if what you're saying happens and East Bengal goes up without having to sell out to a principal owner or with some outside party having to come in, and this season we're seeing Mohun Bagan playing East Bengal, then Mohun Bagan ke fans to are going to be livid. They're saying, matlab hume apna club bechna pada upar jane ke liye. और ये लोग मतलब वेटिंग गेम खेलते गए या यू नो दे वर नॉट ऑर्गेनाइज्ड और व्हाटएवर बट इट वर्क्ड इन देयर फेवर एंड दे हैव कम हियर बट आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू टेक यू बैक टू व्हाट यू वर टॉकिंग अबाउट ईस्ट बंगाल एंड क्वेस्ट एंड द रिलेशनशिप नॉट वर्किंग आउट ऑफ कोर्स इट डिडंट वर्क आउट एंड क्लियरली यू कैन मेक आउट देयर वाज अ लैक ऑफ ट्रस्ट इन बोथ पार्टीज राइट देयर वाज अ लैक ऑफ ट्रस्ट फॉर द ऑफिशियल्स देयर वाज अ लैक ऑफ ट्रस्ट विद इन क्वेस्ट नाउ इफ समवन हैज दैट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक रंजीत एंड यू आर सेइंग आई एम कमिंग इन टू बाय योर शेयर्स टू हेल्प यू टू स्टे अफ्लोट सो दैट यू डोंट हैव टू सेल आउट You don't suppose that trust factor will be there. It won't be there on you. See, where they're going to be saying, yaar, ye to nahi bechega, bhai.
The point is that I'm not going for Neetu Sarkar and company. Now I'm going there for the fans and East Bengal.
Nahin, toh wo agar bolen ki likhit mein do aap. Aap likhit mein doge ki main shares bech dunga. Mere ko koi wo nahi hai ki main rahunga aur.
Haan, that I can give in writing. That I'm doing it for sporting rights and I've got no problem in selling the shares off. As long as obviously not at a loss. I obviously am not going to sell at a loss. And as long as I'm okay with getting my money back and help East Bengal. At least that, see, the legacy is not winning titles. This will be legacy. Making sure that I'm there for East Bengal when they needed me the most and they are now stable where they're not even getting to play in the Calcutta League. So that
if
is...
If that happens, they're going to, at least from someone who loves East Bengal, wo to sir, aapko zindagi bhar yaad rakhenge. If that happens, I'm saying. But there's a big if, Ranjit. I'm just saying there's a massive if.
And this if, I have doubts of this ever happening because they will actually go out. I can have, you know, pictures of these guys, officials going up to the begging bone and actually begging people that please do not let this happen. So they will try their best and that is why now they are clutching at straws. And this is what makes it even more dangerous.
It's interesting actually that you sorry to interrupt, go on.
No, I'm just saying it because see, the reason I'm trying to do it is because Quest was clutching at straws and trying to get as much money they could out of it. Now East Bengal is doing the same thing. Now I don't really hope they don't come up with some investor who takes more than his pound of flesh in the contract for just giving them that money.
Hmm. Yeah, and it's interesting because a lot of the points that you've brought up, including sort of whether it's due diligence on the part of the minority shareholders, whether it's actually having those conversations with the people who are those minority shareholders, all of these things come into play and how little actual information people have. You know? Whether Ranjit Bajaj is being painted as a Punjabi guy coming to take over a section of Calcutta.
वो भी होता है, वो भी होता है, हाँ, सही बात है, बहुत बड़ी बात है।
बहुत सारी चीजें हैं और and I don't doubt that like in some fan groups, in some circles.
I am being very honest. Indian football cannot survive without East Bengal or Mohun Bagan. Simple as that. For 100 years we were kept alive. The history book of India, if you take Calcutta football out of it, the history book of Indian football will be 3 or 4 pages long, man. The entire, we have been, when there was no football in India, these two clubs or giants have kept it alive. And I truly believe that unless these two clubs are there, the future of Indian football is very bleak. But I truly also believe that if these two clubs are doing really well, we just need 2 or 3 giant clubs. If these 2-3 clubs are doing well, our future will be better because these two clubs are doing well.
Bhai, you have a questions because I think we're done with the East Bengal topic, but we got a lot of questions on Facebook, which is why actually I kept on looking down, guys. I wasn't being rude or something. So I'll just send a few questions across your way, Ranjit. Is this really happening? वो ठीक है उसके बारे में बात कर दी. What about Mohammedan Sporting? They are also an important part of Indian football. Why are they not joining ISL? Okay, buddy, we'll talk about that in some other show. Mohan Bagan has sorted retained colors in badge. My question to Ranjit sir is, if East Bengal will wait for relegation promotion or it will directly join ISL?
I don't think there's any point of joining ISL, especially it's going to be a tournament which is going to happen in one city, and it's and that is also because they think that Calcutta will be okay by that time.
No, sorry. One sec. It cannot be Calcutta because the YBK is going to be off limits. So Goa is literally the only option to host the ISL. And in any case, they have to host two tournaments. So if, you know, the chances are that Goa will get the ISL and
yes, so that's what I'm trying to say. The, and on top of that, there's going to be no crowds. If the whole thing about getting there, spending so much of money now, I would never say that. I would rather do it with promotion, first winning the league next year. In fact, it's in the contract with them that the league winner of this year and the next year are allowed to make a bid as long as they fulfill all the criteria, they can get in as well. People are forgetting that. Yeah, they are saying promotion and relegation will start in 23. Yes. But there is a contract which says for the next 3 years, the winner every year has a chance to go in. And if that contract is applied, ISL, see, at this time, ISL is a property which also needs help. And the only way they can reignite the property, imagine next year's ISL has Mohan Bagan and East Bengal. It is double the property already.
Fair enough. Bhai, do you have anything more to say? Because then I'll just end it with all these people who are sending their comments, so अक्सर हमारे show पे comments आते नहीं, तो नाम तो लेना उनका बनता है।
हाँ मतलब मैं बस आपके पास कुछ सवाल हैं। बस I'll just say thanks and bye to Ranjit and like I didn't expect it to be also such a sort of organic advertisement for a lot of the coverage that Newsleak has done in terms of because we talked about I mean you've talked referees, you've talked about coaches, all of these, you've talked about education. All of these things which we've been going on and on about in the context of sport. So, if you and you're watching, please do check out some of our rest of the stories. Great to have you on the show after a long time. And also, one more thing that actually we were sort of touching on briefly in the show that we did about Mohan Bagan was that one of the things that was quite vital in about having these major entities in terms of East Bengal and Mohan Bagan, that they kept the otherwise powers to be of Indian football in check. Yes. They could ask questions.
Yes.
So when these people also transition to the Indian Super League, as they will eventually, it'll be good to have some loud voices doing this key pushing.
My biggest achievement, which has not happened for 100 years in Indian football, is getting Mohan Bagan, East Bengal onto the same table, into the same cause, and just because they were there, just that group of five clubs, not because of us, were able to stop ISL, Ambani, everybody, because they were together. So if these two clubs are there, they are more powerful than the AIFF. It's as simple as that.
Guys, main thoda yahan pe sawal to nahi, but I'll just read out the names. This is brilliant, man. There's a lady by the name of Grishma Nair. She's saying, I have an important question, comma, what's happening here? She's saying, why are you guys not sleeping yet? Grishma, because hum to khane ke bolne wale log hain. Hame to bas chahiye ek platform chahiye aur fir hum to morcha leke shuru ho jate hain yahan pe. And because our ideologies are mixing, you won't be surprised ki hum ek satta mein ek party dal rahe hain, football party. And vote for bolna hi baki hai, to usme aur kuch hai
nahi. Yeah, I'm telling you, we can talk, and this is all, people don't know that this is all not fixed. We're just coming and talking about it, and it matters so much to us that we can just go on about it.
We can, I know. I think NewsClick wale Facebook page band kar denge, so I think hame band karna padega. Rishabh Nagpal, Talste Bhatta, Anveshan Chakravarti, there is then Mohammed Akib, Arjun Sabarwal, Ronak Killinger, Ananda Acharya, Nathan Khargaonkar, Ronak Killinger again, Hanu Trivedi, Pratap Shekhawat, Prasad Bhosle, Rohit More, Anuj Gupta is watching. My dear friend Gupta ji, so jao, mere bhai. Nadeem Suhaib, Rishabh Nagpal, Aman Kumar, Justin Katiam, Atul Pandit, Mohammed Yunus Khan, Rishant Rana, Atul Pandit, Nish, Hanu Trevi, all these guys are there. So guys, I think I've taken all the names.
God,
much love.
good thing even for this time of the night. That means, see, Indian football is loved.
Alive
and well. It is loved, yeah. So, ये तो है and actually the thing is बात करने के लिए बहुत सारी चीजें हैं तो you know why not but Ranjit once again taking our time and thank you so much for joining us on the show मजा आ गया बात करके I hope you enjoyed it as well
yeah, I enjoyed it a lot and it was really awesome man and it's always lovely being with you guys man
तो बस हमने तो यही लाइन चलानी है हमने लास्ट की and we said Ranjit Bajaj is on our show बस ये लास्ट की लाइन चला के thank you so much for watching yahi tha but much love Ranjit to you and we hope whatever your endeavors are man going forward in football may you achieve them and if you have since you're on the platform if you want to make a plea to East Bengal fans and I don't mean officials I mean people who care and love the club if you'd like to make it please do and then I'll shut the show
my only plea to them is that don't fall for the trap which has been set by you by the economic powers that may be They're trying to tell you that you need the ISL more than they need you. No, it's not true. Even if you sit quietly, next year you'll get a better deal and you will be there. There's no Indian football without you guys. You have to have patience because if you do that, you can take your club to a much higher level. On top of that, I am here to support East Bengal. So if there is a way, we can do it in a way that, you know, if it's all about getting the sporting rights and getting it out of the hands of Quest and back to you guys, I'm here for you guys. I'm willing if your officials are telling you that, no, oh my God, he will not sell the shares. I'm willing to give it in writing also. So these officials have nothing to stand by. And if there is someone who's willing to risk so much of his life for you guys, for the club, they should understand if the officials are against it, there has to be some third consideration here. Because end of the day, if all parties work towards it, now is the time. We can go so far. East Bengal deserves better.